So far, I've been encouraging the use of branches for any changes that you make in order to protect your master branch. We'll start to see why using other branches for development is helpful when you're working on a team. In this video, you'll be exposed to a typical GitHub workflow. The workflow will guide you on one of the most effective ways of collaborating using GitHub. The workflow that I'll go over looks like this. Generally, a change is requested through an issue on GitHub. A team member can take that issue and create a branch to address that issue. You then address that issue by making changes on your branch and utilize commits so your collaborators can see how you approach the resolution of the issue. You will then push these changes to your GitHub repository. In GitHub, you'll then create a pull request. A pull request is a way to have your collaborators review your work. They can review code with comments and make suggestions. Once you and your collaborators feel the code is in good shape to include into the master branch, you can merge it into your remote master branch on GitHub. At this point, everyone can pull these changes down to their master branches on their local machine. And there you have it, a typical GitHub workflow. Let's go ahead and try to emulate this workflow for this lesson. In GitHub, I've been thinking about the Hello World repository that we've been working on, and I want to add another translation to the README. I'm going to click on Issues and create a new issue. I'll title it Italian Translation and leave a comment. It would be nice to add an Italian translation to the README. Excellent, my issue is now considered open. If I click on the Issues tab again, you'll notice that all my issues will be listed here. Open means that an issue is currently in the queue to be worked on, and you may have guessed close means that the issue has been addressed. I'm going to open up Hello World Repository. Here I'm going to create a new branch called Italian Translation. I'm going to make the change in my README in my working directory. After that, I'll go ahead and stage the change and finally commit it. From here, I want to push these changes to GitHub with git push origin and the name of my branch, Italian Translation. On GitHub, you'll notice a prompt here with my new branch's name under the text, your recently pushed branches. You'll also notice a button at the end of the prompt that says compare and pull request. You're welcome to use this button in the future, but I would like to show you another way of doing this by going to the tab that says pull requests. Notice that there are no records of opened or closed pull requests. Let's open one. In pull requests, there's a button that says new pull request. Once clicked, you'll see this compare changes area. What we'd like to do is compare our Italian translation branch to our master branch so we can merge it. You'll see that once we choose our Italian translation branch to compare to master, we'll see the diffs below. We can now click create pull request. I can leave a comment to my collaborators here mentioning the changes I made on the branch, but what is really cool is that I can reference the issue I'm addressing using a pound sign or a hash followed by the issue number. So I want to add the phrase fixes pound sign one. I add the keyword fixes and the issue number because once my work is merged, it will automatically close the issue for me, which is a great feature. Then I'll create the pull request. Here, your whole team can do a great deal to collaborate. First, let's go over how you can add reviewers. If you've added teammates as collaborators to your repository, you'll see them listed when you click reviewers. You can choose the person you would like to request a review from. Otherwise, you can just leave this area blank. One of the nicer features is that you can go to Files Changed, and again, you'll see the diff of the code. Here, you can single line comment, so I can put great change, as well as apply a review of the changes by clicking Review Changes. Here, your reviewers can leave general comments, approve a pull request, or request changes. This is great for student collaboration, as well as teachers who are providing feedback for student work. I can go back to the conversation tab and let's say my team is happy with my changes. Great, I can go ahead and click on the merge pull request button and my changes will be merged into the remote master branch. It's good practice to delete your remote branches after a merge so they don't clutter your branches list. If I check issues now, you should see that my issue is now closed. Back on our local repository, I get the changes from my remote master branch. In this case, I trust that everything in my master branch is what I expect it to be. So instead of fetch, I'll go ahead and use git pull to fetch and merge my remote origin master branch into my local master. I'll use git log to double check that the changes were pulled. Great. There's the new commit. You have nearly every tool necessary to be effective with Git and GitHub now. We need to cover one more lesson so you'll have the basics under your belt.